Ricardo Padilla. He is the co-director, co-founder, and director of the Latino Comics Expo. So at this point, I'll turn it over to Ricardo.
Thank you. First of all, I want to welcome everyone to our panel. I appreciate everybody coming. First panel of the day. At least you get nice and rest before you start getting on the bienvenidos to all our Spanish-speaking friends. De todo corazón, thanks for coming out today. Like the gentleman said, my name is Ricardo Padilla, the co-founder and director of the Latino Comics Expo, which I'm proud to say is the largest gathering of Latino and Latina comic book artists in the country. This June 1st and 2nd will be our third annual expo that we have in San Francisco. If you guys are not doing anything June 1st and 2nd, it's at the Cartoon Art Museum in San Francisco, one of the few museums dedicated to the art of cartooning and comic strips. It's a beautiful museum in San Francisco. And we're proud. The Latino Comics Expo, you might say, why Latino Comics Expo? Why do we need a Latino Comics Expo? It's not anything where we're trying to separate or we're trying to be better than anybody else. But it's a unique opportunity for Latino artists to come together, to help each other. Basically, the majority of the artists are self-published, do-it-yourself, unique, original creators doing something totally different with their own vision. Of course, influenced by their own cultural backgrounds and traditions, but of course, mixed with their American experience, with all the great pop culture, movie, TV influences. And what it does is it creates something totally original, totally beautiful, totally different, and in the end, totally American. Is really when you look at it, it's like we have something to contribute to one of the greatest American art forms, which is cartooning and comic stripping. So that's why we're really proud that we were able to create a Latino Comics Expo where people can come together and help each other and share ideas. Today's panel, we're going to share some of the participants of the Expo, and they're going to share their influences and their background, and hopefully that'll be meaningful to all of us who care about cartooning. Let me introduce the panel first. It's a very distinguished panel. To my right, I have the artist Rafael Navarro. Many of you may know him. He's a Zarek Award-winning. Yes, he's a Zarek Award-winning creator of El Sonámbulo. People may know him from the whole lucha noir genre. He's a wrestler who's also a detective who solves crimes and can read dreams, and it's a beautifully rendered comic strip, and we're happy to have Rafael Navarro here with us today. Also to her right, we have Ms. Graciela Rodriguez. She creates her own self-published novel as well, Lunatic Fringe and Spadra. One of the important things of the Latino Comics Expo is we do totally encourage Latinos to create their own comics. One of the proudest things about last year's expo is that we almost had 50% of the participants were Latina. So we don't play. And we're happy to have Graciela here today as well. We also have representation from the Caribbean. We have Senor Jose Caldera. To many from his Crying Macho Man comic strip. He's also been our graphic designer for the Latino Comics Expo. If you see the lovely poster for our June show, Jose Cabrera has contributed our poster art every year, and we're lucky to have him because, like I said, Latino embraces a lot of things. It's people born in Mexico, born here, born in Anaheim, born in La Puente, the Caribbean. We even have some Jewish Americans. We don't check your your DNA, your birth certificate. That's the good thing about the Expo. That's the good thing about the Expo. We're an equal opportunity group. And then our last panelist, I'm proud to say, is our my co-founder as well of the Latino Comics Expo, the creator of El Muerto, the legendary comic book, and that it was made into a feature film starring Lord Marvel the Mama, Mr. Javier Hernandez.